this is a new reporting feature for the new Power Apps based Field Service Mobile. It is fully offline supported, and it's integrated into the application with a PCF control. And so the basic scenario is the service technicians on site, whether they're in a basement or somewhere with good Wi-Fi access and connectivity on their phone, they will be able to consistently pull up a report, show it to their customer, draw signatures, or sometimes the technicians themselves have to sign off on the work they're done, so they would sign themselves, and then send that to their customer as a record of work that was completed. We generally refer to this as a service report. The service report is integrated into the application as a PCF control. So currently it will be a professional developer developed report. We would provide this PCF control as a sample, an example that the developer can work against. So they would download this package that we will provide. It would have all of our template report available to them that they can view and see how we created the sample report. They would update their branding, they would update their logos in the report. If there's additional data or layout areas they would need to do, they would have to do that. And then they could publish this PCF control back into their org, just like any other PCF control. And then the reporting functionality would light up in their application or on the web. And we will demonstrate this today. So I think with that, let's just jump in. We can show a few examples on and show how it works consistently on the web and mobile, and then talk a little more about questions and answers if you have anything. So first, let's just show mobile first. This is the primary use case on mobile. So for example, I have a booking. Generally, this would happen after the booking is complete. Just for demo purposes, I just have a new booking. Very simple to execute the report. So in the commanding bar, there's a more option. Currently, my application is offline. I would click report, and there it is. The report itself there's a preview shown directly on the page. Depending on the width of your device, you may have to scroll a little bit to see both borders. But all the data in the report is pulled down from, if you're offline, it's pulled from the device's cache. If you're online, it would start with the device's cache and work. It's follow the standard online-offline behavior of the application. This sample report is what we're shipping out of the box that you can, this is a reference to update. It would populate products and services and continue to populate those type of details as many as there are on the work order. There's also a signature field. We use a standard signature field from the Bookable Resource booking form on this, but we also position it below the report. The general workflow would be you review this report with your customer. They can see the details of what was done. It's okay. You go down below, you can sign it. Let me try this again, Dave. Check. And so I accepted the signature, and the signature is now on the report preview. So they're previewing exactly what they would ultimately get in their inbox. Okay, I have just saved this report. And now you can go back to your notes tab. You can see in the time, let me save this report again. This is still a work in progress, so if there's any minor bugs, we would be working those out. Okay, so currently it's not saving back to the timeline, but normally you would be, the flow here would be you'd save this back to your timeline. You would show your report, go to a separate work order, which should have a report saved to it. Yeah, so in this case, we've been testing quite a few in this org. There's a number of reports saved. So generally when you click save, it would save it back to your timeline and you'd be able to access your report from there. You could open it up on your device. And then if you so choose, you can see this is the report that you had previewed before. You can also use your standard device controls to send the report. On the back end, you could also create a Power Automate flow to automatically detect when a new report is saved against a booking, and then automatically mail that to the bookinger as you so choose and as you set up that flow. We can also demonstrate the same thing works in the Field Service App module from the desktop client. So again, there is a report button here. This is the nice preview of the report. In this case, I have no products and service tasks set up in this org. Again, you have your signature. There's the signature, and you can save your report. In this case, it will save to my, I'll be able to download it to my desktop so I can do whatever I want with it. And then it'll save back to your timeline, where you can also open it on your desktop and see that report. Okay, and so that's the basic flow of this report. I think other things to point out is we would support online, offline. When you're offline, one caveat is you have to have the data available to the report in your offline profile. If it's just pulling in data from the typical work order, generally that would already be available. But if you're pulling other entities that may not be directly associated with that work order, you'd have to make sure that they are included in your offline profile for it to be downloaded to the device and available for the report. Also, the the person that's generating the report doesn't have to be the technician. As we demonstrated, it works on the web. So if the back office needed to generate the report after the fact, they could always do that against the bookable resource booking in the work order. I think that's in a nutshell that summarizes it. You have any questions, Dave?
Yeah. Thanks, Jonathan. So, without getting into the details, what's the general flow of how I would go about customizing the report to change the fields and maybe put in my personal company's logo at the top? You said it's a developer experience, but can you just maybe at a very high level say what that flow would look like?
Yeah, so we will, as I mentioned, we'll make available a basically a zip file with all the source code of this report. We'll provide a package which will actually be a solution, so you can install this, demo this, see how it functions. But we'll provide the source code as well, and the developer would download the source code. They could use whatever their favorite IDE is to that they would work with this in. The UI is basic HTML, CSS, JavaScript built in React. And they would need to modify, if they like the current report, the out of the box report, it should be pretty straightforward. Update a logo, maybe update a font or something like that. Depending on their corporate style guide. If they need additional fields and things, it will be up to them to lay out the new report, using CSS developing the UI of this. We will have, the sample report does include the API calls to show you how you get your data from your device and things like that. So it'd really be just replicating that for every new field you'd be adding to the report. From there, you would, you save that package up. The platform provides PCF tools that will allow you to upload that package, publish it back to your organization. And with that publish, it would suddenly become available to your users.